Corona time. Corona time. Hey, it's Corona time right now. Corona time.
I just found out that Coachella just got fucking canceled over the fucking coronavirus. And guess what? I'm not even upset that I spent $6,000 on a non-refundable travel package with a VIP ticket and house in Palm Springs. I'm fucking upset that I don't get to show up to the Met Gala of Influencers to get my fucking Instagram pictures. Now let me tell you something. I finally have over 100K followers, so this is the first year where it would actually fucking matter if I went. I don't care if I get the coronavirus. It'll probably make me look super skinny in my pictures from shitting my pants. I'd cancel fucking Coachella. Like, what the fuck?
Hey guys, welcome back. It is now day 4 of this whole mess, I guess you could just practically say. News updates for today is Canada has closed their borders to anyone trying to get in, unless you're a family member or someone there, or have some kind of importance. Or if you're a citizen, you can go back home, obviously. So they closed the border. San Francisco has a curfew, I think it was like 6 or 8 o'clock now. A bunch of our places are starting to get curfews. So I wonder if that's ever going to be happening here. Which is crazy, but wouldn't really exactly be surprising at this point. Like I said yesterday, found out I'm not going to have a job for a couple weeks. If not 2 months, possibly. So that's really, really bad. The thing is, though, I am, myself, not worried exactly about getting it and surviving it because I'm young, I'm healthy. I could have it, but not, it could not affect me, but I could still have it and spread it. I think I'm more afraid of the whole economic and the whole, like, world collapsing, like, socially collapsing. Because people are just freaking out. Businesses are shutting down. Everything is shut down. Everything's been turned upside down. I've never seen anything like this before. I think the more scares me about how people are reacting to it and people are just going crazy. And the whole economy is just collapsing. Stock market had its worst day ever. I think we're down like 3,000 points. So I think I'm more worried about everything happening just socially. I think it's a good way to put it, because people, so far we have no riots, we have nothing really that crazy going on, but yet this is very, very, very early on. We have a long way to go, and now they're saying that life might not get back to normal again until August. That is absolutely insane. We have all April, all May, all June, all July. Probably around 4.5, close to 5 months or so. Could be sooner. Could be longer away. The thing is, though, for being a first world country, we have practically, as of right now, there's some places that have tests. But other than that, it's really hard to find a test. It's practically almost impossible. For being a first world country, we are handling it as United States of America. We are handling this whole situation very, very poorly. Also, if you're, I'm gonna put some videos to, I want to show you guys. People are not taking this seriously. people are acting reckless. People are acting stupid. You're not supposed to be going out in public. A lot of people are going out in public places still. Like I said yesterday or the day before that, people are still going out for St. Patrick's Day. People are still going to bars. People are just not caring what's going on. I see people's Snapchats. People are sharing drinks. People are doing this, everything they're not supposed to do. Meanwhile, they can have it. It might not turn up. It might not get sick, but they can still spread it to other people. People that have not so good immune systems, people are old, people have other issues. They can get it and they can die from it. I'm not exactly sure how many cases we have so far, a couple thousand cases right now. We have more in the United States now and more close to here where I live in PA. But we're more and more. The thing is, though, we would have a lot more, but like I said, we don't have tests right now for them. So people aren't getting tested like they were in Europe and Canada and China and everywhere else. China's on their way getting all these months later, 3 months later. China's starting to bounce back a little bit. They kind of have their cases kind of like leveled out a little bit. And they seem to have everything really under control. So it's going to take about 3 months. 3 months or so. That's about what it took them in China. So it's going to be a long run here. It's going to be a long running vlog series, I feel like. But I want to document everything I can, because like I said, this is a very, very extremely unique situation. Never thought it would come this way. And the fact is that Donald Trump is handling everything so poorly. I think he cares more about stock market than people getting tests. They knew. We had 3 months to plan before, but this was all happening in China. They should have been preparing for this. He just joked around about it and didn't care, and now we're paying the price for it. When it started in China back in December, we had all those months to get ready for it, but failed as a country and as our leaders of the country have definitely failed us, for sure. People are saying, oh, you're probably really a true Democrat right now. I'm as dead center between the Democrat and Republican as you can get. I am as dead center as you can get between those two. I just don't think he's a good leader. I see what he's doing. I don't agree with what he's doing and how he's handling it. He's handling it very poorly. We should be having tests. We should have been prepared months ago for it. They knew it was going to come over this way eventually. Also, like I said, people are just being clout chasers on TikTok and YouTube and all over Instagram, all that kind of stuff too. You guys probably see it. People posting stupid stuff for views and likes and all that kind of crazy shit. I saw a video earlier, maybe, Matt. You probably saw on my Twitter. Some girl had, the thing was the coronavirus challenge or whatever the hell it was, and her licking the toilet seat on an airplane. Like, how stupid are these people? Like, they're going to be upset when them or themselves get sick or someone they know dies. They're going to be crying about all over Twitter and Instagram and TikTok about that. But yet, they're the ones doing the stupid things, which is probably going to cause it for them. I swear, I don't know if it's America. I don't know if it's this generation. I'm speaking like I'm older. But we really, for being a first world country, we have some really, really low IQs for being a first world country. You can go on there and you can see all the dumb shit people post on there about it. People are not taking it seriously, and it's gonna really come back to bite everybody eventually. This has potential to kill a ton of people. I know it's only like, what, 1.5% or 2.5%, whatever it is, fatality rate. But if everyone gets it in the United States, that's still many thousand people are gonna be dying. And if the whole world gets it, say if all 7 billion people would get it, and then you would calculate in the 1.5 to 2.5 death rate, that's still between 100 and 200 million people dying. I know it sounds like a low percentage, but it adds up. I don't think definitely people around here are not taking it seriously. I know I kind of did it at the beginning, but I was always kind of worried about it. But like I said, for myself, I'm not, this sounds kind of selfish, I'm not worried about it affecting me. I'm worried about it affecting everybody else, and socially too. I'm worried more about the social impact of it. So like I said, I have videos up here I'm going to show you guys. You guys probably see. If you guys missed out, all the other videos will be around here for the last couple days. So make sure you guys check them out. So hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you guys tomorrow.